Hi everyone, welcome back to Appa Kopili School online classes. This is Seema KN, your maths mentor. So in this session, we are going to revise the lesson and division. So in our Google classroom, that is Kidwinta has given the lesson, that is division. So in this session, we are going to revise that lesson again. So you know how to divide? So in a fraction lesson, I explained that how to make a equal parts in a given collection. So what do you mean by division here? Yes, very nice. So division is nothing but a dividing into a equal group. So division is nothing but a dividing into equal group in a given collection. Okay. So division is nothing but dividing into equal group in a given collection. So up to here you have no. So then how you have to divide the numbers, or how you have to make an equal group in a given collection? For example, if we have a 6 stars, how many are there here? There are 6 stars. In that you have to make an equal group. How you make an equal group? We divide it by 2. Why? You divide it into 2 equal groups. You are dividing the given collection into 2 groups. If you are making the 2 groups, you have to divide it by 3. If you are making the 3 groups, you have to divide it by 3. So like this, you have to make an equal group. That is about the division. So here I am making the 2 groups. It means you have to divide it by 2. How will you divide? First, you have to count how many stars are there. Come here, how many are there? There are 6 stars. 6 stars. So, in a given stars, I am making a 2 group. 2 group means what? You are making a, dividing the groups into 2 equal parts. That is about the division. So, if you are making a 2 groups, what you have to do? You have to divide it by 2. Here you have to divide 6 by 2. Why 6 by 2? Your total stars are 6. You are making a 2 groups. If you are making a 3 groups, what you have to do? You have to divide it by 3. What does it indicate? Here you are making a 2 equal groups. Here you are making a 3 equal groups. So divide it 6 by 2. So before going to divide, you have to see the given number is there or not in the table. What is the table you have to take here? 2 is a table. Right here. So this is about the table of a 2 is a. So how you have to divide? Before I said that, so here 6 is there. How you have to take a number? That number should be nearest to this number, or it should be same to this number, or it should be smallest. What is the condition here? It should be same or smallest. Then it should be nearest. How you have to select a number here? The number should be same or it should be smallest. This number should be smaller than 6. And one more is, it should be nearest. Nearest means not 7. You have to take a 5. Why? Because the number should be smallest. Yes? So divide it. 2, how much is 6? See here. 2, 3 is a 6. 2, 3 is a 6. You have to subtract here. So 6 minus 6 is 0. So this is about the division. What are these all of? What we have to call for that? So always this number is divisor. This number is divisor and this is quotient. And what about this number? This is dividend. This is dividend. What about this? This is the reminder. After dividing the number, what will get the remaining thing? That is remaining number, what we call? Reminder. The number which is going to divide, that is dividend. The number which is going to divide, that is divisor. So what about this? This is the quotient. So this is about the division. Next, we are going to study about the relation between multiplication and division. So already you have studied multiplication lesson. So now you have to find the difference between multiplication and division. So what do you mean by multiplication here? Multiplication is nothing but the repeated addition. What is this multiplication? Repeated addition. Repeated addition. Here in division, we will do repeated subtraction. So, for this, what we have to come to know here? This is multiplication and division are the reverse operation. In multiplication, we will do repeated addition. In subtraction, we will do subtraction. In division, we will do repeated subtraction. So, these two are the reverse operation. So, in your multiplication, how will get? If you multiply any two numbers, we get the product. If you multiply any two numbers, if you multiply any two numbers, we get the product. Or if we take instead of number, the numbers we also call as the factors. If we multiply any two factors, we get the product. How you get the division? If we divide the product by any of its a factor, dividing by any of its factor or a number. So how will get the multiplication factor? If you multiply any two numbers, we get the product. How will get the division? That product can be divided by any one of its a factor. We get the product here. For example, 5 is 15. Yes, here 5 is also a factor. 3 is also a factor. What about the 15? 15 is the product. What does it mean? If we multiply any two factors, we get the product. What about the division? Division is nothing but the product is divided by any of its a factor. 15 divided by 3. Or you may divide. So this is about the division. So product can be divided by any of its a factor. You may divide by 3, you get the 5 as the quotient. You may divide by 5, you get the 3 as the quotient. So this is the reverse operation, multiplication and the division. So this is about the difference between our relation between the multiplication and division. Next is properties of division. Properties of division. You know the multiplication factor? Properties of multiplication, you know? What is the properties of multiplication? Tell me. Yes? Very good. So the properties of multiplication is, if you multiply any number with the 1, you are multiplying any number. You may take any number 5, 3, 2, any number. So if you are multiplying any number with 1, what will get the same number as the product? If you multiply any number by 1, you get the same number as the product. This is the property of 1. Property number 2, if you multiply any number with 0, you get the 0 as the product. So this is property 1 and this is property 2. These two are the multiplication properties. These two are the multiplication properties. What is the multiplication properties? If you multiply any number with 1, you will get the same number as the product. If you multiply any number with 0, you will get the 0 as the product. So these are the multiplication properties. Now we will study properties of division. What are the properties of division? So property 1. If we divide any number with 1, if we divide any number with 1, we get the same quotient. Example I am taking here. This is the property 1. Example, if we divide any number by 1, we get the same number as the quotient. How will you divide? Here 5 is the divider and 1 is the divisor. 5 is the divider and 1 is the divisor. So how will you multiply? 1 5 is a 5. 1 5 is a 5. Always you should mention the symbol. So in division it is a repeated subtraction. So you have to mention the minus symbol here. So now you subtract 5 minus 5. There it is 0. 5 minus 5 is 0. What is 0 here? 0 is the remainder. So what is the quotient here? 5. So what does it mean? If we divide any number by 1, we will get the same number as the quotient. So this is the property 1. So property 2. What is the property 2? If we divide the number by itself, itself means same number. For example, 3 divided by 3. What are these two numbers? Here 3 is dividing by 3. What does it mean? The number is dividing by itself. Itself means same number. So 3 is divided by 3. So the number is dividing by itself. Divide it. What about 3 here? 3 is the divider and divisor. So 3 ones are, you should multiply here. 3 ones are. Where you should write? Here? Down. 3 ones are 3. Next, what you have to do? You have to put the minus symbol. Then you have to subtract. 3 minus 3. 0. So what about the quotient here? Quotient is 1. Right here. What does it mean? If you divide the number by itself or divide the number by the same number. The number is divided by same number or itself, the quotient is 1. This is property 2. Next, property 3. I'm explaining by examples. So, third property is third property is, if we divide 0 by 5, 0 by 5, what is the quotient? Divide it. 5 is the divisor. 0 is the dividend. If we multiply any number by 0, what is the product? How did I explain? Yes, very good. If you multiply any number by 0, you get the product as a 0. If you multiply 5 into 0, what is the product? 0. So 5 into 0 is 0. Put the minus symbol, subtract. 0 minus 0 is 0. So what is the quotient? 0 is the quotient. So what does it mean? If we divide any number by 0 or 0 divided by 5, what does it mean? The quotient is 0. This is about the property 3. Next is property 4. Property 4. What is the property 4? 5 divided by 0. What does it indicate? What is that indicates? 5 divided by 0, it means you have to divide 0 by 5. You have to divide 0 by 5. How? Is it possible? Is it possible?
No, it is not possible.
So these all are the properties of division. Property one is, if you divide any number by 1, you get the same number as the quotient. Property 2, if you divide the same number with itself, you get the 1 as the quotient. If you divide 0 by 5, you get the 0 as the quotient. If you divide any number by 0, it is not a possible. So these 4 are the properties of division. So next is long division. In long division, we have to divide 3 digit by 1 digit, 2 digit by 1 digit, and 4 digit by 1 digit. So here we have to divide 3 digit, 4 digit, and 2 digit by a single digit or a 1 digit. For example, 42 by 2. Now I am explaining long division with the example. First I am considering dividing by 2 digit by 1 digit. Example, I am taking 42 divided by 2. So here 42 is the 2 digit number and 2 is the 1 digit number. What I am doing here? I am dividing 2 digit number by 1 digit number. So here 42 is the divider and 2 is the divisor. I already explained that before going to divide, first you have to write the divisor table. This is easy to divide. So here 4 is there. I already explained what number you have to take. I said that the number should be same, the number should be smallest, and number should be nearest. Nearest means that should be smaller and that number should be nearest to this number. So here 4 is there. What you have to do? You have to check this number is there or not in the table. So is there? Yes, it is there here. 4. 2, how much is the 4? 2 2 is 4. If you multiply here, 2 2 is 4. Right here, down. First you have to multiply 2 2 is 4 with the minus symbol. Next, what you have to do? You have to subtract 4 minus 4 0. So this is over. What about the next? Here 2 is remaining. So you have to copy here down 2. Next number you have to write down. Again, you have to do the division. How will you do the division? Again, you have to see the table. If it is there, write, multiply here and write down. So here 2 is there. So 2 1s are 2 with the minus symbol. 2 minus 2 is 0. Yes? What is the quotient here? Quotient is 21. What is the remainder? Remainder is 0. What is this? This is the division of 2 digit number by 1 digit number. Next, 3 digit number by 1 digit number. Next is 3 digit by 1 digit. Example, 426 by 2. The 426 is the 3 digit number and dividing with the 1 digit number. Here 2 is the divisor, 426 is the divider. Dividing 426 by 2. So already I have written the table of 2 1's table. So it is easy to divide it now. So again 4 is there. 2 how much is the 4? 2 2's the 4. Always write with the negative symbol, minus symbol. So 4 minus 4 is 0. Next, copy the next number, 2. So again 2 1's are 2. Subtract, 2 minus 2 is 0. Next is 6. Copy the number 6. 2 amas the 6. 2 threes are 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. So what is the quotient here? 213. What is the remainder? Remainder is 0. Yes. What is the divisor? 2. What is the divider? Is 426. Like this, we have to solve the problems with the different examples. This is about the division of 3 digit number by 1 digit number. Next is 3 digit number by 1 digit number. It is over now. Next is 4 digit by 1 digit. I am taking the example 3968 divided by 3. So here 3968 is the 4 digit number. I am dividing with the 1 digit. Dividing by 3. Here what you have tried? You have tried the 3 ones the table. Tables are very important, children. You have to prepare the tables up to 20. So, what is the divisor? 3 is there. When the 3 on the table, now you are easy for to divide. So, 3 ones are 3 ones are 3 with the minus symbol. So, 3 minus 3 is 0. Next, copy the number 9. So, 3 how much is the 9? 3 threes are 9. So, 3 threes are 9. So, 9 minus 9 is 0. Copy the next number 6. 3 twos are 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. Copy the next number 8. So, 8 is there? No. What is the condition? You have to take the nearest number and it should be the smallest number. So here 6 is the nearest number. If you take the 9 number, it is the greater than a 8. So it should be 6. So 3 twos are 6. So 8 minus 6 is 2. So right here, what is the quotient? 1322. What is the remainder? Remainder is nothing but whatever the remaining in the after a division. Here 2 is the remaining. So 2 is the remainder. So the divisor is 3. Dividend is 3968. So like this you have to solve the problem. This is about the division of 4 digit number by 1 digit number. Next is division of 2 digit number by 2 digit number. You may say dividing by 10. You have to divide the number by 10. So I have taken an example as 63. So 63 divided by 10. Here 63 is 2 digit number and 10 is also a 2 digit number. I am doing a division of 2 digit number by 2 digit number. Dividing. Yes. Write the table. So here I am doing 63 by 10. So what number I have to take here? See, 63. So 63 is there in the table? No, it is not there. So you have to take a 60. If you take a 70 means it is the bigger number. So you have to take the smallest number here. 60 is the smallest number. 10 how much is the 60? 10 6 are 60. Write with the minus symbol. 6 minus 6 is 0. What is the remaining? 3. Yes? So, we have divided 2-digit number by 2-digit number. So, 10, 6 are 60. 63 minus 60 is 3. So, what is the question? 6. What is the remainder? 3. That is, we have to solve the problem. So, this is about the revision of a lesson number 5, division. So, like this, you have to solve the problems and write the exam. Thank you.